your genial host, may I offer a toast to the wine-buying guest on my right.
Hooray for the wine-buying!
Yes, drag out the cooking sherry for the old colonel. May his bank account grow, heavy laden with dough. May he spend it in here every night.
Every night!
Seeing this night in its glory, you people so loyal, so true, puts me in mind of a story.
Tell us about it, pray do.
The people in the ballroom were stuffy and arty, so I began to get just a little bit afraid. I sneaked into the kitchen, I dug me a party, the waiter
and the porter
and the second story maid.
I peeked into the parlor to see what was a-hatching, in time to hear the hostess suggest a charade.
But who was in the pantry a-laughing and scratching?
Old waiter
and the porter
and the upstairs maid.
When they heard the music that the orchestra played,
the waiter and the porter grabbed a hold of the maid.
Then they all proceeded to go into a clog.
Hot diggity dog.
If ever I'm invited to some fuddy-duddies, I ain't a-gonna watch any harlequinade.
You'll find him in the kitchen applauding his buddies,
the waiter
and the porter
and the upstairs maid.
Well, pardon me, folks. The roast is carved, the wine is served. Why, you look half-starved.
Pardon me, sir, may we be free?
The kitchen crowd is having a jamboree.
I went and got a dishpan to use as a symbol.
The porter found a regular glass that he played.
The fingers of the waiter were each in a thimble.
You should have heard the music that the combination made. Marching through the kitchen to the pantry and back. Well, man, you should have seen us. We were bowling the jack. Once a half an hour passed without any call.
Jack, we had a ball.
The waltzes and mazurkas, we hate them, we spurn them.
We got a lot of rhythms we want to hear play.
Yes, and we know who to go to when we want to learn them.
The waiter and the porter and the upstairs.